Clearly, improving human capital development must be a priority of public policy. Indeed, given the scale and extent of multidimensional poverty in Africa, governments have a moral obligation, nay, a duty, to put human capital development at the very top of their concerns. The moral case is clear, and it is also in our collective interest to do so.
The Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, narrates to an audience at the Africa Studies Center in Oxford slow developmental strides in Nigeria and Africa's human development outcomes.
The poor and destitute find it difficult.
Poverty is a direct consequence of poor human capital development. Destitute families, he notes, do not have the wherewithal to invest in their children's education or health.
In Nigeria, for instance, 72% of healthcare is paid out of individual pockets, which means that the poor and destitute find it difficult to access even basic health services. Unemployment rates are high on the continent, simply because the number of new entrants to the job market far outstrip the pace of job creation.
If illicit financial flows was arrested, the Vice President believes Africa would have met its Millennium Development Goals by 2016. The government must now take urgent steps to address the many lapses.
Poverty, illiteracy, destitution, and a lack of jobs and economic opportunity often feed into feelings of marginalization and dislocation. These in turn manifest in social tensions, in communal conflict, and sometimes over conflicts over scarce resources as a result of population pressures and environmental degradation.
One of the challenges properly articulated by the Vice President is that of demography, our exploding population, and whether it will be an opportunity for us or a source of peril. And it is very clear from what he articulated in the lecture that there are things we need to do as Nigerians and as Africans, because Nigeria is one-fifth of Africa.
The Vice President inaugurated 9 members of the International Advisory Board for Africa Studies Center.
It has become increasingly clear that more resources should be injected by governments across Africa into the economy to end decades of neglect of basic infrastructure and push forward a more sustainable future for the less privileged. Gloria Umezuke, Channels Television News.